This is one of the worst military accidents in modern history. One Marine was killed while eight others are presumed dead, including one Marine from Montebello. Tonight, their family is sharing their grief.
I'm gonna miss him with all my heart, and he was such an amazing soul, like I said. He had so many goals.
The Barranco family is heartbroken over the tragic accident that took the life of Lance Corporal Marco Barranco. This heartfelt memorial sat up outside the young Marine's home in Montebello.
That was the baby of the family, so, you know, we always looked out for him. He looked out for us as well. Since he was a baby, for Halloween and stuff, he would always wear, like, the G.I. Joe soldiers. He would always want to do that. His room was decorated with, like, camouflage.
The circumstances surrounding the 21-year-old's death are difficult to understand. Barranco was one of 16 service members inside an amphibious assault vehicle when he began sinking off San Clemente Island Thursday during a training exercise. Eight troops were recovered from the waters, seven of which survived. The bodies of the remaining eight are still unaccounted for. After an extensive 40-hour search, the Marines called off their search and rescue operation.
I was kind of mad at everyone, at the Marines and stuff, but at the end of the day, like I said, it was an accident, you know, it could happen to anybody.
Seven Marines and one sailor are presumed dead, including 19-year-old Private First Class Brian Baltierra of Corona and 21-year-old Corporal Cesar Villanueva of Riverside. Officials are investigating what went wrong as they've suspended all water operations involving those transport vehicles. The Barranco family wants closure.
We're really just trying to keep praying, you know, just to find him and get that closure. But if he died, we always talked about that. Like, if I die, don't be sad. Just know I died doing something I love, and that's all I could hold on to.
And the family tells me it's hard to believe what happened, but are hoping that his body is recovered soon so he could get a proper burial. That's the latest from here in Montebello. Carlos Salcedo, KTLA 5 News.